Hi, I'm Rabbi Chaim Miller, and I want to talk to you today about my new book, The Practical Tanya Part 2, which is called Gateway to Unity in Faith. And the reason why this is so important is it encapsulates the vision of the Baal Shem Tov. The Baal Shem Tov was Rabbi Elezer, Rabbi Yisrael ben Elezer Baal Shem Tov. He lived about 200 years ago in the southern part of Poland, and he taught a new path of Judaism which radically reinvented everything we knew about God. We always knew that you could find God in a synagogue, in Torah study, in a mitzvah, in a religious ritual. We always knew that. But could you find God in a table, in a chair, when you're walking down the street, when you're waiting in line to buy something in a store? Could you find God then? So the Baal Shem Tov taught us a way in which we can find God at all times, not just in religious moments. And he developed this consciousness when he was in the mountains, the Carpathian mountains, talking to the animals, and he just began to feel that the whole universe is saturated with God. And really the Zohar says that, if you read it literally, the Zohar says, "Leis asa panu minei," there is no place devoid of God. And the Baal Shem Tov took this literally, that every flower, every stone, every rock, every thought, every word you say, everything that you look at, God is in that thing. Now that's kind of a nice idea emotionally, but our senses tell us otherwise. We don't see God, we don't hear God, we feel our bodies, we feel sensory pleasure, we see sights. Our senses really don't tell us anything about God. The way we come to God is through our intuitive mind that processes all the data of the senses. So what this book basically tells you, how to reprogram your mind so that everything that you see and hear and contemplate will find the presence of God. And for that, you need a new operating system. You know, if your phone is not working properly, you download the new operating system and it makes it work better. And that's what you really need to do with your mind. Your mind is not working properly. You have learned, your senses tell you God is not here. I mean, he might be someone you can in heaven that you can pray to when you're in trouble. But is he actually here in the things that your senses see? Your senses tell you no. So you have to reprogram everything. That's what this book does. And the way it does it is a very profound thought. And I'll try and just sum it up for you like this. Basically, in traditional Jewish thought, you have God, who then creates the world. Okay? So God is not the world. He's the cause of the world. He's bigger than the world. But he's also beyond the world. Okay? Now, in Hasidic thought, in the Baal Shem Tov's revolution that we have here in the Practical Tanya, what happens is God packages himself in like a capsule, and then that capsule becomes the world. And the way that works is like this. Now, obviously, God is not actually the world. God's not a tomato. He's not a chair. He's not a table. But to create the world, God packaged his energy into little packages. And then those packages, with a bit more dressing up, became the world. So the world is kind of God dressed, God's energy dressed up. It's not the whole of God. God's much bigger than the world. But the energy which is coming from God is actually becoming the world. And we could depict that in another way. You see, the philosophers have terms for this. There is theism, which means the belief in God. Then you have pantheism, or the Jewish version is monotheism, which means one God. Then you have pantheism. So pantheism means that God is nothing other than the world. And pantheism was really, each movement kind of rejects the other. It says, pantheism says, no, I don't like theism, because theism says God is beyond the world, he's out there, he's not present, he's not here, I can't access him, so I don't feel close to him. So pantheism re-envisioned God as, really, he must be in the world. But the mistake of pantheism is to say that he is the world and nothing beyond it. He's just the world. So then, what the Baal Shem Tov's revolution has been explained as is panentheism. And here's the important part, the letters en, which means in. Panentheism means the world is in God. So God exists. He becomes the world, but not all of him becomes the world. Just some energy that pops out of him becomes the world. Divine energy becomes the world. And there's plenty more energy which doesn't become the world. But what the world is made of is actually God. The substance of the world that you can feel and that you can see is actually God dressed up. It's the energy of God dressed up. And that's why once you understand that and you meditate on that and you contemplate it, you begin to realize that God is everywhere. We're just bathing in God. We are, if you like, ripples on the ocean of God. Just waves of divine energy. And in the next video, God willing, I will explain to you how the Tanya teaches that idea in a very profound and very practical way.